And we'll be back in Chigwell next year when Birds of a Feather returns for a brand new series.
Sunday, take a seat for laughs and gas galore when Terry Wogan presents a new compilation of Auntie's Bloomers.
And they called it puppy love.
I don't want to lose.
With more Auntie's Bloomers this Sunday at 7:15 on BBC One.
Good morning.
Hi there.
I'm Sally Cumbernauld. This is Martin Crosthwaite.
How are you?
Oh, chipping in already.
Keep watching for a feast of handy hints in Victoria Wood's All Day Breakfast in 10 minutes.
Now, at 10 to 9, the news on BBC One with Chris Lowe.
Good evening. The Israeli government has refused to allow the Red Cross to take emergency supplies to more than 400 Palestinians deported to Lebanon last week. The Israelis say the Lebanese government is responsible for their welfare, but Lebanon's prime minister has rejected this. The Palestinians are camped on a hill outside the Israeli-controlled security zone. It's freezing cold and food and fuel are running out.
The Palestinians trapped in South Lebanon are enduring ever-worsening conditions. Their food is running out, they have no fresh water, and perched in the bleakest of terrain, they are very cold.
Israel was going to make no decision about letting aid through until the regular cabinet meeting on Sunday. But some ministers, unhappy with that delay, forced a special cabinet session this afternoon.
It was a close vote, but Israel's unyielding Prime Minister, Mr. Rabin, won the day.
The government of Israel do not see any good reason to respond positively to the request of the International Red Cross Committee to bring this convoy through the security zone.
The cabinet's main concern was to avoid being involved in the fate of the deportees. But left-wing ministers called the decision a mistake. One said, "We could have demonstrated our magnanimity." On the streets of the occupied territories, there have been more clashes today. Israelis and Palestinians as far away as ever from understanding, tolerance or peace. Justin Webb, BBC News, Jerusalem.
In her Christmas message, the Queen has said she has been deeply touched by the sympathy and understanding her family has received. She said it has been a somber year. The Queen and most of the royal family have spent the day at Sandringham.
It was a depleted family group at church at Sandringham this morning. For the first time, Prince William and Prince Harry were without their mother on Christmas Day. She was more than 50 miles away at her brother's home in Northamptonshire. Her absence and that of the Duchess of York were the clearest signals of the divisions that have made this the most traumatic year of the Queen's long reign. A reminder of a recent happy royal occasion was the presence of the Princess Royal and her husband of less than 2 weeks, Commander Timothy Lawrence. The Queen's Christmas broadcast was recorded at Sandringham House for the first time in 40 years. There was controversy when it was leaked to the Sun newspaper. In the broadcast, she does acknowledge her family problems.
Like many other families, we have lived through some difficult days this year. The prayers, understanding and sympathy given to us by so many of you, in good times and bad, have lent us great support and encouragement. It has touched me deeply that much of this has come from those of you who have troubles of your own. As some of you may have heard me observe, it has indeed been a somber year.
The Queen paid tribute to service personnel trying to keep peace abroad and to aid workers endeavouring to bring food to the weak and innocent. Christmas, she said, was a good time to focus on the problems of others.
1993 will certainly bring new challenges, but let us resolve to meet it with fresh hope in our hearts. There is no magic formula that will transform sorrow into happiness, intolerance into compassion, or war into peace.
The Queen recalled Christmases at Sandringham as a grandchild and said the continuity represented by her own grandchildren's presence there had been a great source of comfort in a world of change, tension and violence.
American and French troops have secured a strategic town in the northwest of Somalia as part of their operation to distribute food to the worst areas of famine. More than 25,000 people are said to be starving in Hodur, and until now the town has been virtually cut off.